In an earlier step, we looked at how applications are organized into different layers. We have a web layer, we have a business layer, and we have a data layer, and sometimes an integration layer, and additional layers on top of this. However, there are certain things which are related to all the layers. There are things like authentication, logging, which are actually functionalities which would concern all the layers. These kind of functionality are called cross-cutting concerns. For example, let's pick up logging. In different layers, you'd want to log appropriate information. So it's a cross-cutting concern. The business layer needs to be concerned about it, the web layer needs to be concerned about it, and the data layer also needs to be concerned about it. So almost every layer in the application needs to be aware of the logging. And let's say authentication. Let's take a distributed system. I mean, the business layer probably is on a different server from the web layer, and therefore the business layer should worry about the authentication as well. It needs to check who's sending the request to it and based on it react to it. So authentication is also a cross-cutting concern. Let's say your application has a built-in performance tracing mechanism. You want to find out at every layer how much time is being spent. This is also a cross-cutting concern because I would want this to be present in almost every layer. The best way to implement cross-cutting concerns in today's world is using something like an aspect-oriented programming. We will look at aspect-oriented programming in detail during the others section. So in others, we have a discussion on AOP and how it helps everything. So we would discuss a lot more about cross-cutting concerns when we talk about aspect-oriented programming. Basically, cross-cutting concerns are those concerns which are not restricted to a specific layer. Thanks for joining more than a million students who are learning from us. At In 28 Minutes, we defined a learning roadmap for Java and front-end developers. We created more than 25 courses covering all the topics that you are seeing on the screens. There are four things you can do to make best use of these courses. Number one is Udemy. You'll find a link in the description of the video to our Udemy profile. We are teaching a lot of courses on Udemy and most of them are free. Number two, visit our website www.in28minutes.com. You'd find tons of information including how you can register for our trainings and the link to Udemy and our GitHub code as well. Number three, visit our GitHub repository. With more than 20 repositories covering varied examples, it's a comprehensive source of information and code. Last but not the least, you'll find a set of discount codes for all our Udemy courses in the description as well. Feel free to use them. Good luck from the team here at In 28 Minutes, your destination for high quality step-by-step courses.